I didn't see it on me, just generally. Was there a specific one on us?
No, not one related to you, but it was built around. This is a routine type of analysis they make when someone like Mrs. Johnson that goes abroad. If you were to go, they would have done the same thing. The analysis would have come out the same way. I have no problem, but I could double check that with them. But there was no discussion of your going when they made the study.
But this one says CIA report on security condition Mexico, the problem to them, estimate the likelihood of incidents which would endanger our embarrass Ms. Johnson, Secretary Rusk, during their visit to Mexico City, and says, however, the possibility of assassination attempt by an individual can never be excluded. The Mexican government might be less able to ensure security outside of Mexico City. So,
yeah, that's the report.
Yeah, I read that.
So I think it really depends on whether you would like to do it. I think if you were to ask me and Freeman and Frank Gordon, that the three of us would say it'd be a pretty good thing to do. The Vietnam business could be a little messy, and it might be a little difficult to get a road for along, but that's only a good hour on Thursday and come back on Saturday. There's not a great problem there.
Well, I might just go and appear at ceremonies and then get on out of Mexico City while you all stayed around there. I might go on down to Acapulco or come on back home.
Uh-huh.
And I don't know if staying there 2 or 3 days whether I'd want to, but I think I could attend the ceremonies. Or do you think I ought to stay all the time?
Well, I think if you attended the ceremony, you'd have to let the president entertain you a lunch and a dinner or something.
Yeah.
You couldn't go without it. So you'd have to spend a full day there, I should think. But in any event, I think it would be important that if you do go, we ought to be able to talk quietly to the president about it, not later than Monday. So we're going to have to do some additional things if you came down.
All right.
Now, on Vietnam, Lodge has got the message clearly that our discussion of the Da Nang business was an exceptional case, and that we're in favor of doing whatever is required throughout the rest of the country to maintain order. And I'm sending him another message to clarify that. He came back and stated his understanding about it. So we're confirming that still once more, so that he's under no misapprehension on that. They'll have to use video force there, I think, before they're through.
What do you think they will do?
Well, the Buddhists have put out a communique that sounds a little equivocal in terms of timing, but if adult Buddhists begin to join these kids in the streets, it could be troublesome unless the government moves on it right away at the very beginning and not let it grow. And they've now diverted one of those battalions that they were going to send to Da Nang to Saigon for riot control purposes, and I would think we'd want Lodge to understand that we think that a government's got to govern, and that they should do whatever's necessary to maintain the elements of order there.
I sure do. I'm afraid we waited too long in Da Nang. We ought to move on that right at the beginning, but I guess not.
By the way, Mr. President, I'm going to the Churchill statue unveiling in a few minutes. Did you sign that proclamation?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
I signed it yesterday.
I was going to read the proclamation out.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I signed it yesterday.
Okay. Fine. Well, I'll keep in touch.
Now, Dean, what are we going to do? How in the world are we going to justify and explain throwing in the towel if these people just take over that government and run us, tell us to get out? Or if it looks like we're just in the middle of a civil war?
I really don't think that we're moving to the point where they're going to ask us to get out. I think that they have talked about a constitutional...
Are we moving to the point where it would be difficult for us to ask people to continue to die out there, this kind of stuff going on every 2 or 3 months?
I think not yet, sir, by any means. I think that this is still a minority problem. It's still in the trank of political palaver, but political talk is not going to be able to get anywhere if they don't maintain the elements of order. And I think myself that we ought to emphasize that directory is the government, that the government can't turn over to a non-government, that the government itself, as announced, it wants to Lodge understands that. We may have to give more direct help in some of these situations than we've done thus far. We've got quite a stake here in having this done the right way and not let the whole thing just go into anarchy there.
Are you breaching anybody like Mansfield, Fulbright, any of them, or is that too dangerous?
I think it's a little tricky at the moment because we're almost on an hour-to-hour basis in terms of what action. I think by another couple of hours we'll know whether that they've had those larger riots that they were fearing in Saigon after the Buddhist meeting yesterday. But I'll be here all the weekend and we'll be on 24-hour duty if need be, and I can keep in touch with you about it.
You know of nothing else I need to know or do?
I think not. There's no particular development in other parts of the world that you need to worry about.
Have we made any more progress on our Brazil man?
Definitely the Colgate man is out, so we're sending along the papers to you on Taco.
Then why don't we rush all those career people like that woman in Tuthill? They all been cleared. Why don't we just rush those so we can get out the announcement so it won't show so much delay on somebody?
All right, fine. We'll go ahead on them.
Tell them try to get them down over the weekend. All the career people that can be consulted, and let me look at them.
All right, fine.
Okay.
Waiting.